The language, I didn't understand all of it. I could understand uno, dos, tres, and that's all you need for baseball, really. So you know the count, dos y dos, two and two, cool. And you just listen for the emotion in the announcer's voice, and you know what's happening. Pepsi-Cola. That stuck that away in my ear. Italian voices were different now. Italian guys, we didn't have Italian guys in my neighborhood. We had to go, when I went to school downtown, when I first ran into Italian guys, street guys. Hey! Hey, sorry about the audio. Hey! Hey! Money was measured in bananas and clams. Hey, you got three clams. Of course, four bananas to get into the dance. I got one bean. You got three clams? A change of a clam. Yeah. Good earth to you. I never heard many Jewish voices except from behind as I was running out of the candy store with $30 worth of merchandise. And... You're a fancy pants gangster! When you hang around a stoop, when you hang around a corner, this was the way the guys in my neighborhood talked. This here was your third generation Irish voice. All the cops in New York have this voice, right? You heard the voice. Come on, Johnny, move along here. Come on. Let's go. Where are you going, Johnny? Hey, Johnny, come here. They call everyone Johnny. Notice that? Never Buddy or Mac or Hey Mac. Say, hey, Johnny, come on. Even your mother, right?
I'm his mother.
Never mind, Johnny. Get off the corner here. Policemen have special phrases in New York City for special events. If a guy, for instance, has a heart attack or something, okay, come on, the show's over. Let's go. Let's go, Johnny. Move it, move it, move it. In there. So you've been asked to move along once or twice, haven't you? Yeah, they have another thing, the New York police, or all policemen, it seems, but I noticed it mostly in New York. When a policeman's on television describing an arrest that he was involved in, they have a special lingo so that they don't prejudice the case for the attorney, I guess, the city attorney. It's like, my partner and I, Patrolman Ryan, responded to a call. We observed the accusee. We surveilled him. And we apprehended the perpetrator as he emerged from an edifice. We got him on a 505.
What's a 505?
That was the number on the edifice he come out of.